opportunity to thank Early Music America, the Bloomington Early Music Festival, and also the staff at IU for making this possible and for arranging everything, including the harpsichords. And so I've been asked to speak a little bit about the program. So all the pieces here are from 17th century Italian people repertoire, and I've chosen them because they're some of my favorite pieces, and I've been playing them for several years. So if I were someone in 17th century Italy, and if I had an iPod, these will be on my playlist. All right, so the piece you just heard is a toccata by Frescobaldi, and it's one of the earlier styles, so you can hear, you probably could hear there were sections, and one idea flows into another. And so two more pieces on the set also by Frescobaldi. The one I'm about to play is a capriccio on the theme of the cuckoo. So this is a falling third. It's a very short motive, so you literally will hear this hundreds of times within this capriccio. And Frescobaldi cast this motive in alternating duple and triple meters, so you'll hear some contrasting tempo and also affects. And then I will be ending the set with a cento partite on Passacaglia. So the Passacaglia is a descending tetrachord, so you'll hear this ground bass over and over again. But very interestingly, first of all, they're actually putting a Tricona dance section in the middle, and you will hear the Tricona again later in the program. And I would say Cento Partite is one of my favorite pieces, and it really shows first of all, his mastery in writing variations. So I hope you enjoyed this. Thank you.
Thank you.
fun piece. And so, more on the program. So the next set will be kind of from the middle of the 17th century, keyboard repertoire. I'll begin with Rossi Toccata, which is also sectional, but different from the first Vivaldi one because it's almost rhapsodic, like there's no connections you can do in between sections. And the Rossi Toccata is probably very, it's a pretty famous piece among the harpsichord repertoire because it has a very chromatic section coming up. So I should probably say a little bit about the tuning today. I have my lovely harpsichord technician, Laura, is helping me with my the tuning today. And the Italian instrument is tuned in quarter column tone with modification because I'm using almost all the inharmonics on the keys today. So in the traditional quarter column tone instrument, we're going to hear very pure thirds for certain thirds, but not all intervals. So in harmonics such as an A flat, if you tune to a G sharp and then you play an A flat, say an F minor chord or A flat major chord, it's going to sound very out of tune. So that will really bring out the crunchiness in the Rossi. And then I will end the set with a Ciccona by Storace. It's very different from the Ciccona that you hear from the Cento Partite. It's a much thinner texture, but it moves along in different tonal areas, not necessarily tonal. But it's a really fun piece, and you just want to dance to the piece.
Thank you.
from Rossinello by Poletti, and he's kind of from the later 17th century style, and he was actually working in the court of Vienna. So his music can has some influence from the German style as well. And so I have five pieces from Rossinello. The first one, oh, I should say, Rossinello means nightingale. So this is this was my DMA research project, final project, and I was exploring how to use harpsichord to imitate, you know, sound or image or something. And so Rossinello came in, you know, at the right time. And I'm beginning with the toccata, very different from the two toccatas you just heard. It has a very free section to start with. Then there's a more contrapuntal section, so it's more like the later toccata that you know from 18th century. Then followed by two richer parts on this theme, and the second richer part is a variation and extension of the first one. Then second to last piece is Capriccio on this bird theme. I don't think I have to talk very much, you'll hear the bird in that thing, in imitative texture. And the last piece on the program is this free piece. I'm taking it with a lot of artistic liberty, and this is the place to do that. And I'm using as much as I can to imitate birds, and I'm picturing birds chasing each other, birds crashing into a tree, or the echoing of the bird call. So I hope you can see that for me. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.